The last week at school was a typical offline school week. We got a bunch of group activities which made the week very busy, interesting, and way more effective at studies. So I decided to make this video's topics 5 group activities you can do at your school and make your studies more interesting, fun, and knowledgeable. Hey guys, I'm Arashi and you're watching Good Vibes. Number 1, popcorn reading. So popcorn reading is basically when children teach topics. So our English teacher conducted this activity for us. He first of all chose the story, Expert Detectives, Honeycomb, NCERT book. Then he divided us in groups and then he gave a part of the story to every group. For example, one of the groups got from the introductory paragraph to paragraph number 2. Then another group got from paragraph number 2 to paragraph number 3. Like this. So what is, and then we have to teach those paragraphs to whenever the activity is going to conduct. So we are given dates and at that time we have to explain the topic which we got. So it's a really fun activity. Our English teacher promises to give this activity in grammar topics as well. So you can try at your school this one. It is one of my favorites. Yes. Number 2, a science presentation. Our science teacher gave us this awesome activity on science presentation. He divided us in groups and gave us some topics. Then he told us to make a PowerPoint presentation or Google Slides presentation on those topics and gave us some dates. On that day, we have to present our presentation, PowerPoint presentation, and we have to explain the topic. Of course, sir has explained the topic to us already, and we have to just revise that topic and make it more clear to students and ourselves as well. So, you know, a science presentation is perfect one to do something technical and, you know, to make things fun. Yeah. Number 3, a typical Marathi drama. So this activity was given to us by our Marathi teacher. So she divided us in groups, we chose our topic and we did a typical, just a normal act drama on it. So we, make scripts, we practiced it and we conducted in our auditorium and it was such a beautiful thing. You know, just check this out.
नमस्कार नमस्कार बाल मित्रांनो व प्रिय अध्यापिका मी संस्कृती अतुल नागरे आणि मी शिता मलाईक तुमचा मनापासून स्वागत करते आज आपण पाहणार आहोत आनंदीबाई गोपाळराव जोशी यांची गोष्ट
संस्कृती तुला माहित आहे का आनंदीबाई कोण आहे
की तुला माहित आहे ना माझी विसरायची प्रॉब्लेम आहे मला काही आठवतच नाही तू सांग ना कोण आहे त्या
अगं आनंदीबाई भारताची पहिली महिला डॉक्टर आहे
Not gonna show more than that. So it was fun doing that activity and we took the topic of Anandibai Joshi, who was the first female doctor. You can take your topics according to you and it's gonna be so much fun. All the best. Number 4, a Sanskrit workshop. So our Sanskrit teacher organized a Sanskrit workshop for class 6th and 7th together. So she divided 8 groups from 6th standard and 10 groups from 7th standard. Then she gave topic to each of the group. For example, one group got fruits, another group got flowers, another group got grains, another got something else and like that. Then she told us to open stalls of these things. For example, if our group got fruits. So we open a stall of fruits with their Sanskrit names. So this fruit, a mango, is known as Amramaha. So I'm going to explain that this is mango, means this. And I'm going to explain. So I'm going to open a stall of it. And then other groups are also going to open stall or all in the classroom. And then one by one, all the teachers are going to come. We are going to explain them. And you know, it's just a Sanskrit stall, Sanskrit workshop. And it's fun. Number 5, mathematics quiz. So quizzes are one of my favorites and was conducted by my mathematics teacher. So sir, the previous day told us to prepare for a topic of, like, for example, squares, square roots, tables, then properties of triangle, like that. And then the next day he would conduct his class, and at the last 15 to 20 minutes he would conduct a quiz between boys versus girls. So yeah, we mostly love boys versus girls, and you know, it's according to you how you divide your teams, but in our class we conduct boys versus girls, and as usual, always girls win. Hi girls, it's absolute fun. We study different topics. हम इस तरीके से डर से स्टडी करते हैं कि हमें हारना नहीं, हमें जीतना है. एंड वी स्टडी इट प्रॉपरली एंड द नेक्स्ट डे वी रॉक. एंड इसके साथ हमारी स्टडी भी हो रही है एंड वी आर एंजॉयिंग इट. ग्रेट. दीज आर द फाइव ग्रुप एक्टिविटीज यू कैन कंडक्ट. आई हैव वन मोर, सिक्स्थ वन. इट वॉज अ सरप्राइज वन. सो इफ यू आर एट द एंड, दैट मीन्स यू गेट टू दीज एक्टिविटीज. सो थैंक्स फॉर बीइंग हियर. सो द लास्ट एक्टिविटी इज द प्रोजेक्ट. सो दिस वी मोस्टली गेट एस एस एक्टिविटीज, सो सोशल स्टडीज एक्टिविटीज. So in this we have to make a project. It may be a wallpaper project. So our once SS teacher sir gave us a topic of Ram Mandir. So we prepared a big project of Ram Mandir. We wrote its architecture, location, material needed for it, and you know, many other information about it, pictures, and we made a whole project about it, and now it's in our class, stick there. So good, right? And and when we were offline, our SS ma'am teacher, she gave us the same wallpaper project, and so we weren't able to make it like a hard copy of it because it was everything online. So we made a website of it where, you know, it's just a website where we conducted poem and, you know, different things like that. And it was such a fun to make things online and offline, and we got a big difference. So these are the six actually group activities that you can try in your school. If you're a teacher, please try this once in your classes, and if you're a student, enjoy it once with your friends. Thanks a lot for watching. Subscribe for more these awesome ideas and creative ideas. Thanks for being there. Bye.